Where's my little favorite car? Oh, it's over here. Car. That's cool. This is my favorite car. I like this one. It's so good. Look, it's got so much space.
It does have a lot of space.
This thing gets 60 miles a gallon. Just reciting things from the pamphlet. I can do that. I don't like how it has a parking brake with the foot brake, though. If it had an E, like an electronic push brake like yours, I would buy it. Look, I got a beer in the car. Off. It's got paddles. Boop, boop, boop. A boop, boop, boop. I want one. It's so cool. And the super lane assist, all the electric gadgets and all the bullshit they add to it. I drove one. I don't care about it. It doesn't matter at all. Yeah. It's like, it's not important. And it actually gets worse gas mileage. It gets 59 miles per gallon with the basic one. And then if you get the one with all the extras, it's actually heavier, and it gets like 57 miles a gallon. Oh. So it's actually better to get the cheap one. Right?
Like, no.
No.
It's fun.
It's not fun for me.
Look at this, like, tomato orange red one. Oh no, they did the thing with the weird screen in the dashboard. Ooh, hold my beer. Hold my beer. I want to play with the stick shift. No cars have a stick shift anymore, so I'm going to play with it. Ugh. So much fun. I didn't know they were still making cars with a stick shift. Because people are masochists. Hey, it's your Kona. How do you have a 1.6 liter all-wheel drive? You drove this thing, right? Like, I didn't drive it. This had to have been the slowest car you've ever driven, right?
No air conditioning.
It was so broken. But, like, it had, when you did drive it, it had to have been the slowest car you've ever driven.
I don't remember. To me, it's all relative. This is the car.
I hate this fucking
weird little stand-up screen thing that they're doing. Mercedes started doing it, and Tesla started doing it. Now everybody's doing it.
It looks like it's broken. Like it's an afterthought. Like you should be able to take it out of the dashboard. It's a booger, Kona. That's cool. It's very boogery.
Ford.
Yeah, but it's a Ford. They haven't changed in fucking 20 years. They're good, but whatever. My $9,800 Fiesta has the same amount of storage. Boo. Oh my god, they're showing off an Impala. What's even the point? This isn't... Where? That's the problem. This car came out 4 years ago, and it overlapped another Impala using the exact same name, but a different body style. And apparently we're supposed to give a shit about it. In we go. Oh, I can't even get into it. I gotta move the seat back. Oh, this is a brand new car and the seat is already worn out. Look, it's blue. The fact that you can't tell the difference is really upsetting, right?
Yeah.
How much?
Too much. So for a third of the price, you can buy a 2015 that looks exactly the same.
Uh-oh, you gonna get in it?
Okay.
Uh-oh. He's like, oh, it's a Malibu. No, that's this one. The one that actually looks like a Toyota Camry, which is kind of better. Oh my god. Oh look, and they're cheating by putting their good red on it.
Yeah, this is decent red. Monster.
It's so boring. Oh, when we were watching, there was a movie. It was like, it has the funny little Mexican guy from Ant-Man in it. It was like 21 Jump Street or 22 Jump Street or something. The beginning of it, he's an undercover cop, and he's like ripping through the town in the Chevy SS, that loud Chevy from your old apartment, the guy in the garage with the loud exhaust. And they set it on fire, like the rival gang or something, like lit it on fire and they blew it up. And he was like, oh no, my undercover car blew up, but whatever. They actually, at the last second, swapped it for one of these. And that's the car they actually set on fire, because the SS is the one that's valuable and the Malibu isn't. But they look so similar that most people couldn't even tell the difference. I didn't even know until I found that out on, like, the YouTubes. And, like, that doesn't say much for Chevy. I can't remember what the hell movie that was. What movie was that? It had to have been, I'm pretty sure it was like 22 Jump Street or something stupid like that. Look, it's a boat. I like how he pulls on the door and it doesn't open right away, so he tries three more times. Dude, no, it's just, it's locked. It's decent. It's not Tesla range, but
it's not a Tesla.
Yeah, but the costs? These things are $33,000. Maybe you're just allergic to Chevrolet. Maybe it's the cup. $43,000. Look at that.
Starting at
37.4. That's too much. 37.5, actually. Ooh, look, Corvette. You can get a used 4-year-old vet for 43 now. You have to add your own stripes, but...
You can paint them on, like nail polish or something.
No one gives a shit about J.D. Power. Remember the Keanu Reeves movie? What was that movie called?
Desperate People or something?
Desperate People. So... Destination Wedding. So you're like the guy who gives out the trophies to the used cars? Oh, look, they're trying to make the Traverse cool looking. Ugh. And then look at this. Does this remind you of anything? That looks like the exact back end of your Ford Escape.
Yep, I've never seen it before in my life.
That whole taillight arrangement and everything is identical to your Ford Escape from like a couple years ago. Yep. Look, they got racing. They have racing. They have
like.
Racing stripes in the wheels. It's weird.
You act like I know what my own car looks like.
I wouldn't expect you to, but I'm still gonna call it out.
Yeah, no, I mean, dude, but I don't know what my taillights look like. Ooh. I almost tripped.
Yeah, there's a hump.
It's a pretty decent hump, too. I can see it.
There's no one.
Yeah, definitely someone.
You could sue somebody. You wouldn't successfully sue them. Let's look at these stupid Hondas. Hyundai. I don't even know who's what now. It's cool. This looks kind of like an afterthought. I'm trying. I'm really full. It's all right. This looks like that stupid Audi A7 that Kevin likes. Where it's a four-door with a hatchback, slopey back. Oh my god, they even like condense them so you can like avoid the boring even easier. This is the one that used to be a hydrogen car, and then it's not a hydrogen car, and that gets worse gas mileage than an 8-year-old Honda Insight. It gets like 41 miles per gallon. But it's super expensive because they advertise how fancy the gas mileage is.
Oh.
This car shouldn't exist.
Electric when you need it. Gas, or electric when you want it. Gas when you need it.
Yeah. It's just like an old, you could buy an old Toyota Prius for a quarter of the price.
Oh, there's a bug. There's a bug.
Where?
On you.
He even recognized I was going to murder him, and he's like, you know what, I'm out of here. Does it have the cool plug-in button at least? Wait, I'm going to do it. Give me a second. So that's the gas cap. It has two holes. Oh, you have to, like, this one doesn't push out like the Ford's does. Where's the button for it? What is it? What is this thing here? Alright, how do you push? So there's a trunk and there's a gas. Gas releases that one. Where's the electric release? I wanna release this one. Aha! I found it. It's in a completely different location. Watch. Look, it's thirsty.
Oh my god.
Boop, boop, boop.
Yeah, because people like me start fucking with it. But they didn't tape up the one that matters. You didn't even close that, by the way. Watch, I can open it again. I'm gonna open it. It's kinda like, it's open. Oh, they put tape on the thing. Boo. That's how you get in and out of the car. Yeah, it happens.
So if you're missing your iPhone, please check your pockets. And if you lost it, please come up to the front desk.
See, the trick is, they've made it now. This is actually a safety... No, it's actually a safety thing. So, see this thing here?
Yeah.
That glows in the dark. Uh-huh. And so you can get out of the trunk if somebody slams you in the trunk. But... if somehow they've managed to stick the trunk closed, they've taken the seat releases and they put them in the back of the trunk. So you can actually pull these and that's how you get in and out of the car. And that's how you break out of a car. It's valuable information.
I think you need a couple more drugs, sir.
Huh?
You need a couple more drugs. That kind of information.
Also, the acrobatic trick is pretty cool. I wish I had a video of that. It was like all ass. I mean, I didn't mind, but there were some small children.
Whatever.
I mean,
it has to be done at least once. I got a job offer out of that. Oh, God. Why do their shoes have like a zit on them? Did I just get a job offer? That's dope. Oh, God, they're so boring. I saw an article today. They were talking about Subaru, too. Subaru is not weird anymore, and that's a problem. Because Volkswagen used to be weird, and Subaru used to be weird, and now they just have these Passats, and nobody cares anymore, and they're not weird, and they're just regular cars with regular oil leaks. It's fucking boring. Jesus. It just doesn't matter. nothing matters. It's all stupid. Who cares? It's got everything's got airbags, and it just everything looks like a fucking Toyota Camry. And you know what? Everybody's got a Toyota Camry, and everybody's gonna crash into something stupid, and then they're all just gonna survive, and then that's it. Then everything's it's so stupid. This car literally has the same wheels as the Hyundai.
This is the electric Golf, and it has the same wheels as the,
oh yeah, I wouldn't recommend buying one of these. This one looks like a pair of sneakers.
I need to get like black socks, like specifically for work, because I always forget
to put them on. It's got a carbon fiber steering wheel.
Let's see how the lazy man's wax.
Why would you advertise that? Still get a manual, huh? Oh, God. It's four-wheel drive. That's cool. It's got an electric... It's got electric parking brake. That's cool. I want to drive another manual, but...
No, you don't. You hated it.
No, but like just once every other week.
You complained about driving whatever it was, the Aston?
Yeah, that car sucked.
All the time. And that was like your dream car or something.
No, it was everybody else's dream car, and I got caught up in it. I didn't actually like that car.
What's wrong with you, then?
I don't care about anything. I just want to see what everybody else thinks is cool, and then I want to buy it and so I can rub it in their face.
Yeah.
I thought that was pretty obvious.
Okay.
Auto hold. It's got the fucking auto hold thing. Is that like the Subaru?
What does auto hold mean?
Watch. Here, I want to put your purse over here. Let me put my beer in the cup holder. Look, my beer's in the cup holder. So it's got a parking brake, the electronic parking brake, which is cool. Not something I'd want on a hatchback. I'd want a manual parking brake so I could slide the rear end around when I want to be an asshole. But this is a four-wheel drive one, so you could do, like, Dirtfish Rally on this one. That'd be cool.
I thought Golfs were supposed to be cheap.
Why is
no.
Why
it $40,000?
Because it's got the expensive engine and it's four-wheel drive. But four-wheel drive is super... $40,000, you could have a Mercedes and $7,000 cash.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying.
But the auto hold, if what I think it is like for lazy people who don't know how to clutch and brake on a hill, like in Seattle.
Yeah.
I can't imagine this button is convenient to use while you're... Yeah, look.
It's for monsters.
Yeah, no, it's... Basically, manual transmission is completely stupid. Mm-hmm. It should only ever exist in a, like, proper sports automobile. You want to close...
That kid's jacket matches this car.
Of course it matches this car. Look at that. This car is, like, fellow kids, right? Ugh. It's got the cool steering wheel with the weird snakeskin carbon fiber wrap. Just, I don't know. Like, I'd rather have this Buick over here. It's a Buick Evanier. What is a LaCrosse Evanier? So it's basically a Chevy Impala Plus. Because the Buick LaCrosse is a Chevy Impala. And the Avenir is what? I think this is the Impala. I think the LaCrosse is an Impala. I actually don't know for sure, and that's not good. It's got a second sunroof.
Which means
that it's probably the Impala. I can't imagine.
Ooh, the seats are cushy.
Yeah, because it's a fucking Buick. I am very pro-Buick. I feel like my attitude might have come off very negative. I'd rather have this than most of the cars here, because I don't give a shit. And look at this. You can just be like, oh, I just want to go forward. Look. Right here. I'm going to put my beer in the cup holder again. Boop, boop.
This is a good car to take a nap in.
So you just go, oh, I want to go forward. Boop.
What do you mean you want to, that's how you put it in drive?
Like, you don't have a park, you don't have the Prindle.
Okay.
Park, reverse, drive, neutral, low, whatever.
I've never heard of that before.
Prindle, you don't know the Prindle?
No.
You just go, oh, I want to park. There's like a button.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I want to go forward. Boop. This is actually what killed the Russian guy from Star Trek.
His Jeep.
Yeah, his Jeep had an overly simplified version of the shifter where it would just go only up and down.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently he parked the car without putting it in like a very deliberate gear. And he ended up in neutral or drive or something where the car would still kind of coast. He got out in front of it to go check his mail. It coasted down his driveway and it crashed into him and pinned him up against a brick wall. Super fucked up.
That was terrible.
Let's see here. Cruise control. What I want cruise control there. Oh, these are weird. They're like, everything is super hyper rubberized. Doesn't feel good. Stop putting phone controls on the steering wheel. No one uses these. Just put a, design a cell phone that has a standardized size and a cell phone holder that holds a standardized cell phone in the dashboard. No one is ever going to use, like, oh, I'm going to put my cell phone in this cup holder.
You just want to put all your beers in the cup holder.
Yeah. Your cup holder is full of beers. That's very important. This thing is worthless. What is this?
For your change.
And you gotta, like, do this thing and empty out the garbage. And it barely fits. And you put it back down. Boop, 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 boop. You get air-conditioned seats. That's cool. Air-conditioned seats just... That's just, like, a big fuck you to nature. I like it, though.
I guess my ass isn't sweaty enough. I never felt the need.
Right?
Maybe because it's Seattle. Maybe in Vegas would be better. All cars have it, pretty much.
I drink a lot and I forget a lot of things. Apparently, not too long ago, like within the last 10 years, I was very anti-air conditioning.
That's
because I drove a lot of really shitty vehicles.
They
and
just didn't have it because it was broken?
No. They didn't because they were just too old and they didn't have it. But I was like upset with the idea that cars would have air conditioning because... That's another failure point.
Yeah.
And I, in my faux retarded engineering brain, was like, why do we keep adding things to cars when we haven't perfected what's already there? Let's stop adding this garbage because it's just another thing that's inevitably going to fail.
Yeah.
And it's never stopped doing that. So I can kind of see, like, what my point of view was 10 years ago. Most of these things don't work with the ignition off. So you have to just kind of deal with it. But
SOS.
Kevin was telling me one day, not too long ago, actually on multiple occasions, was like, yeah, basically, anytime anybody mentioned air conditioning around you, you would get, like, upset and start yelling at people. And I don't remember it, but I can... Yeah.
Okay.
I don't remember it, but I can totally see it.
I can, too.
Because I'm a fucking nut job.
Well, you are very passionate.
boop, about boop. Things. But now I'm like, well, what would I do without air conditioning? I don't know. It would be fine to drive, but it's just, it's not worth the goddamn $45,000 for a front-wheel drive Chevy. And this back seat looks less spacious than that goddamn Hyundai Uber car we were in.
The Ioniq.
Yeah. I like the I. That's seriously my favorite car. Every other car is stupid. This one looks like it has a little bit of space, but it's just an Impala. And it's got this worthless middle seat that no one would ever use. Yeah, back seat, middle, feet on the hump. Yeah. When you tumble through the back seat of a car, you're going to injure yourself. It's fine. I already took a video of it. This is not bad. It's fine. I'll just not do it again.
It's probably for the best. But what are the other wounds you have that I don't even see? Jesus.
I don't know. Is there one over here?
Yes, there is. There's two.
Nah, that feels fine. It's just, it's so boring. Oh my god, I think I just got that kid falling down on video. That was dope.
Uh-huh. Put it into America's Funniest Home.
Yeah.
Little kids falling down is always funny.
It's the funniest, actually, literally. All right. Yeah, of course he is. I did it on purpose. That's why I'm injured.
I know.
It makes for good video. Yeah, but only in spirit. Ooh, they got a Dirtfish car. I'm going to bring my minivan to Dirtfish. Yeah, that'd be so good. Look at the exhaust. It's like pushed up into the bumper. Yeah, it's not supposed to be like that. See how it's melting the bumper? Ooh, they got a go-kart. I want to sit in it. Oh my god, why doesn't anybody listen to me? I could design such a mo better car than any of these people. Look at this one.
Sideways.
It's a sideways car.
It's a real car.
It's not really a real car, it's a Subaru.
But I mean, like, it's like a...
Look at the roof is caved in there. It's just a little smashed. It's fine. It's not even, like, that it crashed so hard. It probably just, like, ran into, like, a big dog. Weird. It's the sexiest of places. Is he doing a number one or a loser symbol? Probably some sort of Fortnite thing. Are you gonna take a picture of me?
Of course, but I don't have any hands. You're gonna have to chug this beer.
Ah, oh, I got out bamboozled.
Let him go.
I don't even think I would fit. I will try, though. I had one of these back in the day. It was 3/4 the size. I got into a lot of trouble. This is way better than mine. Like, literally just, like, the little rubber joints in these things. Like, it's actually built like a car. Mine was just... My dad was like, here's an engine we pulled off a lawnmower, scrape the crud out of it, and see if you can get it running, and I did. And then I would just drive up and down the neighborhood, and like I would drive up to my friend's house, slam on the brakes, and squirt around the corner and be like, hey, and then we'd hang out, and I'm like, all right, we'll see you guys. And I'd pull the gas or pull the starter and just drive away like it was my car. No, me only.
It's gonna look a little
damp now. Sticker. Oh, is this the, Yeah, this is where we went for Kevin's birthday.
Oh, so you do fit in it.
I know for a fact I fit in it, and I destroyed everybody else. I wonder if they have the corner. I almost killed myself. I am still here. I can recognize some of the corners, though. Yeah, no, I did some damage. I didn't quite get talked to, but so oh yeah, that corner and that corner. Yeah. Yeah. No, I wildly overestimate my abilities. Yeah.
So graceful. Come on, let's go.
Ooh. Yeah, the hips don't quite fit exactly. I did some damage in it though. It was bad. I need a go-kart. They need to legalize go-karts around Redmond. That'd be dope. Steering wheel's on upside down. The flat part's supposed to be down here. I can't get out. Stand back here. Let me see if you video. No, I got it. You videotape this. I'm pretty sure I'm stuck. Yeah. You need triceps, literally, to get out of the thing. Ah, I want one. Daily driver. Look at the motor on that son of a bitch. Alfa Romeo?
Sure.
It's funny, Alfa Romeo and then the Pacifica, yeah. Your favorite minivan.
I don't like it anymore.
You don't like it anymore?
I like the old one, I don't like the new one.
The old one is gross.
I like the old one, the new one's just a terrible minivan.
But the terrible minivan has so many buttons.
No.
You like the buttons.
I like the buttons on the Town and Country.
The Town and Country is they don't make that anymore. The seats are all leather and crazy. That's, yeah, that seems kind of a strange choice. It looks like your brother's car in here.
Just go ahead and put my beer in the cup holder. Oh god, my foot's stuck. Hey, look, it's the Prindle I was talking about.
Park, reverse, neutral, drive. Oh. You don't like your low gear?
I don't know how to use it.
Mechanical telescoping wheel? That's dumb.
Oh my god, look how terrible the dash gauges are. I don't know if you can see them.
I can see them. They look like broken cups.
Oh, I can get them on the camera here. They look like they're melting or something. There's something weird about them. Press brake button and push button to start.
So we got brake, which is brake for P. Oh, it just turned off again. Like it cycles or something. Here, like push button. Key fob not detected. Rude. Knob. Oh, the knob is like frozen. They won't let me like fiddle with it. It's like locked. That's dumb. This car sucks. Okay, what's your other favorite car?
The Octavia.
They still make that? They got rid of it. Just so people could, like, jump in and... Why are they still making this car?
Can you make the seat come out?
This car is 12 fucking years old. No, it's physically not there. It doesn't come out of the ground. That's not a fold flat seat. That's a, they remove the seat to show you how much room there is. Yeah, just to show you how much room there is. That one over there has it, so you can see it. Ooh, this is the one I want. Look.
It's electric?
No, it's half electric.
Hybrid?
Yeah, so you can
plug-in?
Give it gas, but you can also plug it into the electric charging thing. So you can have like 14 miles of electric range. I'm going to say 14. Nah, it's 14. And then you can burn the rest of your gas later. Yeah. Do you work for the company? Dude, fucking relax. It's fine. I don't care. You're not going to win this argument.
It's like one of your rental cars?
No, they actually show exactly what it would end up being like. Chock full of Cheerios. There's literal Cheerios in it. Yeah. Okay.
They're your favorite.
No, I like the Hyundai.
You love the Kias. You have like 5 of them.
I have 3 of them. That doesn't count. Look at this kid's shirt. Look at this kid's shirt. This kid's shirt is a... some dumb, low-rent, like, Florida rapper. And he has a shirt, like, that's his Tupac.
Oh.
Yeah, but it's, like, really inappropriate. Because it's stupid.
Yeah.
It's just some Florida rapper that would run around with like $30,000 worth of cash in his pocket, like a moron. And he got shot up outside of a strip club. And you know what? That sucks. I don't encourage it, but maybe don't be an idiot. Ooh, you know what's funny? We need to find a car like one of these with the auto closing trunk, and I'm going to stick my head in it. No, it's funny. People like it. It's funny. Watch this. Watch this. Hey. Hey, watch this. I'm going to do it. And they walk away. Hold my beer. But I want you to hold this.
Nothing's happening.
No.
How do I know what's happening? I can't see anything.
Pointed at me.
Okay. I don't like it when you do that.
It's funny.
I don't have to see you get decapitated live.
I didn't get decapitated.
You know what? YouTube gold. It's already on YouTube. It's live. Can't unbroadcast. Also, why is it gray? It's like, oh, this is kind of a cool car. It's got all these things. It's rear-wheel drive, decent motor. Let's make it gray. Boo.
Why?
They all do come in the same colors.
All different colors.
Their color swatches all look different, but you can get any car in any different color. Basically, besides bright Lamborghini orange and yellow, they're all the same. This is the most absurd one here, this blue, this Caribbean. But most of them are actually available in... What is it? The current runway passion is probably one
but
of the cooler ones. Passion red tricoat versus just regular passion red.
Weird.
Why is there so many individual options?
That's what I'm saying. They just pick 10 colors and all the cars come in those 10 colors.
In a store. Weird. Complicateder. Not allowed. As obnoxious as I am, that is one of the rules of the car show I will not violate. Because then you get kicked out super early, and then you can't keep doing what I want to do. I'm going to look at this Kia Sedona. These are my favorite vans. I don't like the grill, though. The grill is stupid. These vans are so good, though. I have... Oh, my God!
It's got not only a recliner, it's like the movie theater recliner.
That's fantastic. Where... I have... It's the new one. This is the only one that's just after the two that I have. That's dope. And it's got the hand shifter. I actually like the dash shifter in mine, but that's kind of gimmicky.
Whatever happened to vans that
squeeze
eight people?
Basically, the Chevy Econoline, the Ford Econoline vans. Well, people, the captain's chairs, the individual captain, basically offering the reclining middle seats ruins that.
Oh, I know.
But wow, that thing really goes to town. I mean, you can't be a person in the back seat.
Look at this. It's like so low.
No, it goes higher. It's just broken.
Why is it broken?
No, that's not a thing.
All right, we need to find some buttons. There's that middle seat belt. Oh, and these windows have shades.
Oh, that's the built-in.
I like that.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Window shade. Here.
There goes there.
Beer goes there.
Window shade. All right. So, grab the beer. And then this goes... Close it. Yeah, I just got reset or went to some sort of weird safety or limp mode or something. It's funny how much they didn't change, other than the fact that those middle seats recline like a son of a bitch. I like that. Because in mine, the rear seats don't really get used all that often. In the black van that I do, yeah.
Yeah, but in the silver one.
They just don't make those anymore. You just can't. It's a dead concept that I'm surprised that it existed as long as it did. Yeah. Is that the new Kia logo? They actually write out the word.
What did they have before?
Oh, they have like their weird. They have like a number of weird Kia logos, but that like. They actually write out the word Kia now. That's strange.
I feel like they all say Kia.
Not like that. Which one is this one? Some stupid little sedan? I don't care about this. Alright. We're around the wall. We should be able to find it soon enough. No. Alright. I'm farting right now. Alright, now I'm farting. Kia. Is it really down here? I noticed that. Yes, I see a dub. Have you picked your gender? Do you know which gendered bathroom you're allowed to go into? Also, like, men can only go into the M, but did you know that women can go into the M bathroom too? I know. And it offends me.
Thank you. slide it through the bag.
I'm gonna harass the HelloFresh guys about their wine club.
Something fun to do.
No, I was about
to drink your beer.
I was about to harass the HelloFresh guys about their wine club, but I don't know if I have the energy. There's a sign, and these guys look like they're super not.
Well, let's find out.
No, I can't. Let's go look at more cars and go upstairs and stuff.
Got another one? They don't fit in there.
They don't. I could probably make it fit in there.
You probably could.
Watch. I'm gonna do it. I don't get like a refill bonus, right?
You can just leave it there and screw with everybody. Want another beer?
I want one. Do I need one?
Well, no, no one needs one ever.
Yeah. It's pretty smart. You should probably get another beer.
I mean,
beer.
You're right here. You can have a walking beer. Thank you.
It's that one line. You guys are in line, right?
Yes.
Eat.
Nothing happened.
Eat pipe drink.
Eat, I drink.
Eat pipe drink.
Eat, I drink.
That's a pipe.
It's an eye.
That's a pipe.
The skinny eye.
You see how skinny it is?
It's an eye.
Pipe.
It's a skinny eye.
You don't know.
Yeah. Not even the acai berry. They're excellent food safety.
He's drinking beer. He's spilling beer all over now.
The candy's $5.
Candy?
Assorted candy, $5.
No, thank you. If it were $3, I'd be like...
Yeah. Landjager, Bavarian meat snacks.
Meat snacks. You want a pretzel?
I'm actually full. I ate so much ice cream.
This is the most amount of ice cream. Oh my god, I caught something in there. It might be just crumbs. Oh, it's crumbs.
Come for my nachos.
Look at this guy's sunglasses.
You were taking, I know, you were taking so long to drink your beer. I had to eat the whole ice cream. It's your fault.
My camera's still going.
Yay.
It's hot. What is that?
I don't know.
I just spit on myself.
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, I like injured my thumb. Why am I bleeding everywhere? Whatever.
You know why.
I don't know about that one. I know about this one. I'm pretty sure about that one. I have a good idea on this one. Dos por favor.
Do you want two?
Smart.
Okay, let's get two. Yeah.
It smells like deep fried awesomeness over here. Box O Skittles. Mm-hmm. All right. It's a steal.
Bargain.
Look at this. 1997.
That's scary.
That's so crazy town.
Makes me feel so old.
With the super napkins.
Yeah.
All right. Awesome. Thank you, sir. Now.
Like last year when I had the 21st.
Yeah, 21st anniversary of being. Ooh. I don't.
I've now been able to drink for longer than I've been.
My, your ability to drink can drink.
Also, I could, like, have, like,
23 years. And not have people, like, leer at you. Look at this disgusting green Challenger. Where's your brother's... Where's the elephant? They're not going to have that. No, they're not going to have it here. They're the weird, dumb blue Challenger over there. This is like a base model shitmobile.
This one?
Yeah. Ew. And the dashboard looks exactly like the same as the minivan. Look at this one, though. It's in the sexy red. How do you clean under here?
With
Why aren't the door locks?
It smells like gasoline.
It's a new car. It's just a gross. See, the door lock thing, though? Mm-hmm. Why isn't that here? Because that's where your hand would go, right? They've been doing this for how many, like, decades? And they wouldn't put the... Because this one has blood on the carpet. Because Chrysler is retarded. It doesn't matter. Literally nothing that comes out of this company makes any sense. You'd be a good focus group, like, participant. Because you can point out all the bullshit. You're 100% right. You are peeling away layers of the onion that no one have ever even thought of. Look at the fenders. See, this has got fat fenders and that one doesn't? The chunky part right there. See how, now ask questions about it. Why does that exist? There you go. No, I don't need to answer these questions. You just are asking good questions. More dollars. He slammed the hood and then tried to close it and it still didn't close. That was awesome. I want to find out if it's actually broken or not. Maybe. The other one was taped. Oh, he just doesn't know how to close a hood.
Purple!
Oh, I want to find the purple car. Ooh! It's like a Joker mobile. It's a Hemi.
Is this the Hemi?
I had a 1987 Volkswagen Fox station wagon that also was technically a Hemi. Did you know that? No, it is not. But it is purple. And apparently they have bad rear differentials. No. It's just this car is that car, the red one, but it's hooked up to a video game.
What is the difference? I don't understand.
This one's a video game.
I get that, but...
See, look at, see how it's like humping the ground?
Humping the ground, yeah. But I don't understand.
This isn't a real car, this one's a video game car.
This is actually the only good one here.
But it's not actually moving.
No, look at the...
wheels are moving.
Oh, of course not.
It's making noises.
But look,
mounting.
No,
I see
it bounces. That's cool.
Mounting, I guess.
It was a proper simulator. The transmission would have let go by now.
I Oh, look, it's Fun Zone. Oh,
I want this in my living room. This is so cool. You can have a race car minivan if you want. This is actually the only good car they make, except it has four cylinders, and you can only buy it at 24% APR. The hell's a GT? You can buy this loser-ass Jeep. No, it's good. It makes you make friends. You can be like best friends with everybody. You can buy this Dodge Power Wagon with the weird secret doors in the side humps, and it takes up about 89% of the tailgate area. It's got a ram box in it, and it's where you ram your box into it. It takes up so much space. And it has Doritos in it. That's cool. How do I get this in there? Here, hold my beer. Famous last words, right? How do I get this in here? It's so much work. Is this a button?
Open it?
No, I want to put this in it. How do I...
It's not for going in.
No, this is clearly for going in.
It's not. It's for making use of this
It does not have anything to do.
Oh, is there a hump?
That's how it's done. That's really dirty. It doesn't actually like smoothly go anywhere. I thought it was gonna like hide into the body of the truck or something. You just kind of like twist the things and then go to town on it. Here, all right, I want to do the reverse now. I want to see how fast I can do it. That's terrible. All right. You go there and there, and then you twist the thing, and you twist the thing, and then... That's not for minivan moms. That's for, like, millennial dads who think that that's, like, hard work.
Millennial dads aren't buying this.
Well, they're all gay anyway, so.
They can't afford it, and they don't want anything that uses too much gas.
I don't like it. Oh, I'm smelling beer everywhere.
What?
That's weird. I don't like that.
You have your Superman curl.
Look how much space the side humps take up. Why does that guy have a goddamn beanie on?
Because he needs somewhere for his brain to go.
Like, at what temperature, at what Fahrenheit does the human brain take on damage?
In like the Middle Ages, people used to wear those conical caps.
Yeah.
It was like designed, they thought, to focus energy in your brain so you could think better and be smarter. I think that's what those reservoir tip caps are for.
Well, everyone is stupid.
They'll like concentrate your brain energy.
These are not truck tires.
Maybe we're not supposed to be in it.
You That's a camera. At least, like, the Chevys have, like, a shock in them. Chevys are the Fords. They'll go... They won't slam down like this. Yeah, where's your Acadia? Is it Arcadia or Acadia? Arcadia, I think, is some gay hipster band. Yeah. The problem is it's been redesigned and it doesn't look as good, but it's actually good now. Because they're not good trucks.
It's not a truck.
This is the one that's like a Terrain or whatever.
No, a Terrain's different.
Terrain? Which one is the Terrain?
It's the smaller one.
This is the Terrain. The Terrain was always good, but the Acadia... Why is there 75 Terrains? The Acadia is the one that's the Traverse, which actually sucks. Kevin told me that the Traverse is garbage. That's the one that I test drove in Everett, and everything on it was broken. It's technically a new model version, not model year, but it's still garbage. Look. Ugh. Watch your head. Oh, they disconnected the accessory power. Those aren't even good floor mats. They're like styrofoam. They're like aggressive styrofoam. Ugh. Are they magnetic? Oh my god, they're fucking Velcro. Look.
Weird.
But, oh, they recline. Wait. Is this only a 6-seater? Oh my god, I think it's only a 6-seater.
Yeah, it is.
Well, how can you even use this car? I'd rather buy the Kia Sedona. That's like a 28.5-seater. Look, you can tell how shitty of a car it is if it's a push cap on the gas door. This thing, what do they want for this thing?
No.
Oh my god, it starts at $30,000?
This one's $47,000.
What happened to this car?
I don't know.
No.
When they first came out, I really liked
them. No. This thing's unbuyable. Nope. You literally cannot purchase it. And it's front-wheel drive. So, the V, like, you can tell, like, if a car is good or not. If the V of the motor is, like, on the side or on the front. Like this.
I didn't even see a V.
So, see the
black part there?
There's everything in there is black.
No, but that long running metallic part?
That's
the valve cover.
See how it runs left to right? It runs from my side to that side?
Yeah.
Instead of from front to back?
Uh-huh.
That basically means that this car is garbage. Mm. I think it's always been like that. It has, but they never fixed it. And yet they're charging people as if it weren't that. Literally, for, what, 3/4 of the price, I'd rather have that Kia van.
Yeah, the Kia was pretty cool.
Oh my god. And it had reclining seats and 7 seats. Yikes, dude. It's going to have a better resale value, but you know what? I'll just buy the Kia van in 1.5 years and save even more money. These aren't even real seats. Look at this garbage. And fewer and fewer people will get into a vehicle and have any brand loyalty.
Yeah.
Because sometimes it really just boils down to, oh, well, I have a Chevy, or I have a GMC, or I have a Kia. And it used to be, oh, I have a Kia. People are like, oh, well, you're a trash person. People don't care anymore.
No.
This car is literally worthless. If the Kia minivan got all-wheel drive, which it probably will any day, no one would literally buy any one of these ever again. It's just, it's toast. Chevy does everything stupid. I'm always right. They're always wrong. Fuck them. But it's got TV screens folding down in the back, which is cool. With a weird, awkward HDMI plug.
If you're in a car accident, your face can smash right into it. It'd be perfect.
No, there's like an airbag. It's fine. Does this have... Oh, it doesn't even have the cool like Lincoln airbags that are like in the seatbelts. It has normal seatbelts. And it has these really aggressive HDMI ports and USB ports on the screen. This car sucks.
That's sad.
Oh my god, can somebody just consult with me for like a second and design a real car? I could design the best car.
You could. You should do it.
I'm gonna do it. Well, no, I've already done it. Just nobody's gonna give me the bucks. Actually, if I were to design the best car, it'd probably just be this Lexus here, and it's gonna cost everybody fucking $120,000. What does this one go for?
Oh, it's only $90,000. They're basically giving them away.
Boop.
Other than the fact that they're super ugly,
this is literally probably one of the only ones I'd buy here besides the Kia. I'm gonna look at the motor. Boop. That's a gas tank. That's the motor. It's $90,000 Toyota. The Highlander. No, the Highlander. This is the big one, and then it's Highlander, and then it's RAV4. So basically, buy a Highland. It's the 4Runner, I think. I think they still make a 4Runner, probably.
You can tell it's good because the entire engine's covered. Oh, the Sequoia is the big one, yeah. No. It's the Sequoia.
It's funny because you just corrected me. No. You get a weird boner over it. It's good. Look at how much plastic is on the motor. Don't put your hand there. This is not like the trunk where I put my head in it. Well, don't put your hand.
So that you don't sign my hand.
But you then put your hand in it. Is your hand clear?
Yeah. I
kind of want you to. With my other hand, I want to see if I'm smart enough to clear my own hand.
I mean, you're not smart enough, but...
I don't know. Well, my injuries were because I was showing off.
Let me get a thing.
Technically, that's a separate issue. Oh, it's so ugly. It looks like a 75 blade Schick razor. I just said a bunch of stuff. It was just getting juicy is all. Where did my thumb... There, I had thumb wound. I don't know where that one came from. Because I was pretty aware of the elbow one, but I don't know about the thumb one. That was strange. Feels all right.
Barf.
It's okay. You're just gonna be very gnarly for.
It's fine. I should have checked those guys up on their job. They didn't know what they were doing. I could make so much bucks. Oh my god. Other than the fact that I have to, like... Well, I'm clearly already the world's best car salesman, but I can't imagine actually going to a job and doing it. It's not even hard. I just don't want to... I hate... You can do work the late shift. Some places close at like 8 p.m. I could just get up at 11. Cool. I don't have any problem taking their money because everyone's dumb. Yes. You want to do the stairs or the elevator? I don't have no idea. There is an elevator, but I don't know where it is. Restrooms, East Hall. Oh, the stairs look really aggressive. I think we're gonna take the stairs. Oh, this is like my nightmare. Upstairs is usually the cool, like, nonsense. Okay, so this is the Highlander and the Land Cruiser. These are the ones that, like, you're going to spend $80,000 on a Toyota, but you technically never need to buy another car again. But that's boring. Yeah, $84,765. And it's not the car you're like, oh, well, I'll just buy a one-year-old used one. It's like, okay, well, it's $83,765. Fuck. It literally does seat 8, doesn't it? Oh my god. Is there a middle seatbelt in the ceiling? Yes. Look. It's up here.
So it seats 8.
Here, hold my beer. So if you grab this son of a bitch and you pull that down and you pull that up, this is so intuitive. I've literally never seen this car before, and I was able to pull that seat down and back without looking at instructions. And then you plug this in here. Oops. Oh, it got away from me. And then you grab this, and then you've got a middle seatbelt.
So the seat's 8.
1, 2, 3. The middle seatbelt is on the hump, so you don't even have to do a ceiling grab. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, this is literally the best car in the entire building. Wait. Wait for it. Oh, it's not. They disabled it. Land Cruiser V8. This is literally the best car in the entire building.
Yeah, this looks
like no doubt about it, no question. It's a Volkswagen. On a Volkswagen. It's ugly, but who gives a shit? You can fucking put 8 people in this thing. You don't need the Lexus, and it's the same goddamn truck. It literally even has the same license plate cutout. Like, this literally, like, the imprint is the same. That sucks. It's still too much money, but damn.
But it's clean like a jelly bean, man. I like it. These things are about nuclear, too. My friends have one that must be 30.
It's the running joke, right? It's just, it literally, it just is what it is.
I wish they had more like the old style ones, so that you could like hose out, that are meant to get a little scruffy.
You don't want the old ones. They're not that safe in a crash.
For that point, but I mean, just like a little bit more rugged interior. Hoseable.
Well, so we keep evolving and we keep getting farther and farther away from the Oregon Trail. Yeah. It's not that necessary.
No, this is pretty ready to go.
All right. Fuck. Yeah, I got the tent on top of the car. That's pretty cool. I like that. Can you hold this? I want to check my battery. I don't need a 400 though. I don't need any of this shit. This one actually, the seatbelt, it barfs out of the ceiling in such a weird manner.
This also has 8 seats.
8 fucking seats. That's so ridiculous. Okay, here, hold my beer. I want to see, and this one doesn't have the bottom tailgate. I want to see if the bottom tailgate is like matters to me. Whoops.
Somebody's magazine got. All right, so we want.
So this is the big one? Ow! So, the...
$55,000.
Which one is this one? Alright. So it's $55,000. This back seat belt is not as easy to get to. Okay, here. I got it. I think I got a hold of it. 55 is a significant... drop. I just wanted to see how easy the seatbelt, this middle seatbelt, was to hook up. All right. I found a bunch of paper wadded up in the thing, but I'm going to put that there. I just wanted to see how easy it was to get to this middle seatbelt. This middle seatbelt people overlook as being not that important, but if I can get to it easily or enough or not, it makes a difference. It was all right. These seats. Ow! It's all right.
Nice car, though.
So this one's what?
54.
No, this is the Sequoia. What were we just looking at?
Well, a Land. Like the fancy one, but this is like the not as fancy.
I thought the Sequoia was the fancy one.
No, Sequoia just is the regular one.
That doesn't make sense. So for 30 grand, 29 grand less? Are you serious? Well, no, this is the best car here. Maybe it's like a V6 or something. Oh, it's like there's a whole grill. You get underneath the grill. The V8, 5.7. It's got a 350 V8. Wait, what? So what makes this one not as good as the other one?
This is why I need my autistic brother here. What is going on here? Are they giving me Portland prices? I'll give the fucking shit about the miles per gallon. Anytime there's a car that the grill goes up with the hood, that's supposed to be like a shitty thing, but it never actually matters. Alright. So what? Okay. So it's a Toyota Sequoia SR5. It has to be two-wheel drive or something, right? I crawl into the car like a fucking moron. No, it's four-wheel drive. Why is this one... I don't give a shit about leather. For $30,000, you can just buy a leather Toyota Camry.
Okay, so you've got towing mode, four-wheel drive, automatic. You've got a cup holder for beers.
Moonroof. What the fuck? I don't understand what the difference is.
I don't know, it's pretty nice.
This thing's amazing.
Yeah, I like it.
I want one. How do I buy one?
I used one.
The used one's like 8% cheaper.
Can we get a salvaged one?
The problem is with the salvage on these is they have like a full frame. If they've been salvaged, they were in a big wreck.
Huh. On earth causes this to be $29,000 or $28,000 less than the other one.
Boop, 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 boop. It's because it doesn't come with its own beers.
Look at this, the third one.
There's a third beer holder for your beers? Look at that. Boop.
You can have so many beers in here.
Right? You and seven of your buddies.
Two more on this side?
Yeah. Oh, and the cup holders on the sides, yeah.
How many do you have?
I got two, and it gives me an instruction as to whether or not I can hold like a Nalgene bottle or like a regular cup. What is this thing? Oh, it's like a little side bonus unit. I want this truck. How do I buy this? Oh, I don't like that. I hate this. My minivan has this, and it makes me mad. Because it's like, it's literally just for yelling at your children.
I see you.
Hey, this is the, I'm going to turn this motherfucker around.
Jimmy, looking at you.
Put your sunglasses in there. All right. So, you got 4x4, and you can break. Yeah. Tow mode, auto windows. I don't know what auto window. Oh, it's the back window in the tailgate.
Oh,
you can hit up or down, and the tailgate window will just go all the way up if you just hit the button once. You can do burnout mode. You got TCS, parking cone mode. That's good.
That's stupid, but sometimes people don't like to listen to the beep beep beep.
My 100-year-old van has that. USB AUGs. That looks like an afterthought. Look how like this font doesn't match any of the other fonts. This is clearly just printed on with like a...
It wasn't finished. They took the knobs off.
Yeah, they take the knobs off here and here and here because people are... they have sticky fingers. What is this thing? You put like your laptop here? I got a plug plug. Put some stuff there. So this one's $53,000. This is the price of what I would expect this truck to be 15 years ago. So something's wrong, or it doesn't actually come with the engine or something.
I think this is just it. It's just, you know.
Is this like the best truck here?
It's not super fancy, but it's...
Boop, boop, boop. Ah! I want this. 8 seats, huh? What would you even do with 8 seats? This is retarded.
You're a huge family.
Yeah. Oh, no, my phone. Smashed my phone. So, Toyota SR5. So the other one had, like, you know, the button up here. It was like the push the button and it lowers.
Yeah.
That was the only thing I found that the other one had that this doesn't. I thought the Sequoia was the bigger model. Was that an actual 4Runner that we were looking at, or was it like some super model? The one that we were looking at was on the
Land Cruiser. Land Cruiser and Sequoia are the same car.
But it's a Toyota Land Cruiser, Toyota Sequoia. They are not the same car. They're similar, but they're not the same car. Land Cruiser doesn't have the grill in the hood, and that makes a difference. Apparently, it makes it... If you include this part of the car in this part of the car, it costs you $30,000.
That's crazy town. Here, drink this.
What the fuck? Why isn't everybody just buying this thing? Well, yeah, because everybody's a trash person. What? All right. So, now what's the deal with the Highlander? Does it have 8 seats? If the Highlander has 8 seats, then that car's even shitty. Nah, it's tiny. All right. Oh, look at the footroom, though. It's tits.
Yeah, it does have 8 seats, actually.
Well, no fucking way.
But it's so tiny.
It has 8 motherfucking seats? Okay, no, we're doing it. We're getting weird. All right. How do I open this? Well, it has to slide. That is cool, but it does have to do that.
Yeah, otherwise people wouldn't be able to get back.
Look at this thing. I don't know, but I think it's technically an acceptance of a seatbelt. Here, watch this. I like the seatbelts coming out of the ceiling. They're my favorite thing. So... This is slightly different size. I don't know what that is for. Oh. Don't worry about that. It's just a little bit of beer. You know what? It's a good sales pitch because of all the rubberizedness. You know what? I'll just drink that down.
You should. It's all over my hand.
Thank you.
Is it on me?
Don't worry about it.
I just want to know. It's all over.
No. Alright, so this plugs into here. And this plugs into here. So you've got 3 seat belts here. You do have to have a skinny friend. Where'd you go? You do have to have a skinny friend in the back, but that's always the case.
Or, you know, this is where you put, like, the bad little kids.
With this, this is not a child seat, because then you would use a child seat.
I know it's not a child seat, but this is where you put the ones you don't care about living.
That opens up a weird conversation that you're not supposed to have, because people absolutely do not use child seats, like, in Louisiana.
Well, really,
I'm assuming Louisiana.
Used anyway.
But, okay, so you've got 1, 2, 3. And then this thing slant. Oh, wow, that, like, slides really easy.
Yeah.
I'm barely. Watch this. Pinky maneuver. You know what? I want to be extra shitty. I need your pinky. Yeah, I need a tiny little woman pinky to push this back.
Do it.
Do it. Try it.
I have to put more hand into it. My pinky's is bending.
You can.
Look at my pinky.
No. Not direct on, but like this way.
Like this?
No. This way. Yeah. Do it. Try hard. Push.
I have to use more hand.
You're pushing a lot of seat. With a little hand.
It's not,
that's pretty decent. Alright.
My pinky was just bending.
So, not too bad. Here. Oh, wait. I want to drink this one.
It's Bud Light.
It's basically candy.
It's water.
Yeah. Alright. So, these little. I like the little pockets for the seatbelts. My vans have this, where you put the slip. You put the slip here, like this.
Uh-huh.
You see what I'm doing?
Yeah.
But this one has the slip, but then a little extra plug for the seat. It just kind of makes it stand still. It seems unnecessary, but I like it. Stupid. So this seat slides back, click. And you've got this one that goes here. And you've got the back climate bowl. Why would literally anybody buy anything other than one of these fucking cars?
Pop the hood for me.
It's just like a dumb little V6 version of the. They literally have to take out one of the seatbelts. Otherwise, no one's gonna buy that car. And then no one's gonna buy the big one above it. It's bigger, but.
It's wider, more comfortable.
It's $20,000 for a seatbelt.
That's more like a
truck. It's $20,000 for a seatbelt. You know that truck? Versus not a truck thing?
Yeah.
That's what I was trying to explain to you, is the motor.
Well, that's a truck, that's not a truck.
Yeah, so, you know the motor is pointed this way versus this way?
I noticed that. I learned something.
That is what that is. But does that matter?
That's
exactly.
Can I drink this? No way I can throw that one.
So what? $10,000 as trimmed? You... Okay. So, 48, 53.
For 5 more thousand.
For 58 to 43, yes. Even though you probably lose.
No, that's 53, that's 48.
Yeah, but you probably lose how many miles per gallon?
I mean, I could never drive a girl just because I hate going to the gas station. Also, I hate driving, it's a big car.
Where would you ever park that?
I have a parking spot, man.
I park your car all the time.
Yeah, you can just keep parking it.
I'm not gonna park it. Eight fucking seatbelts. Those seatbelts are worth bucks, man. That's so crazy. We gotta go upstairs. We haven't even, like, this is like half the car show. I'm just being a dick. All right, let's go upstairs. I gotta get away from the Toyotas. I shouldn't have gotten near the Toyotas. I apologize. I'm sorry for getting near the Toyotas. Getting excited about the Toyotas. Everything else is stupid. Toyota's the only company that even knows what the fuck they're doing. And this guy's got a metal leg. That's awesome. Are we gonna walk up the stairs? Alright. I want this Lexus. It's ugly.
Here you go first.
Hardest thing I've ever done. Oh shit, they got like a 64 Impala over here. Except it's not completely totaled like Pat's. Oh, they got like three of them. Holy shit. They have like a whole gangster section. They had a convertible one, which Pat's should have been, but he's a loser, so. Bunch of B-body garbage. Oh, look, it's a stock Rolls Royce. That's so fancy. Yeah, gangsters like to pimp out their babies, too. If you're not pimping out your baby, what are you even doing? But, if it makes you feel any better, none of these people have ever had any dealings in selling cocaine. So this is Pat's car, but with some more swirls on it. And it has a goddamn 5 liter of 350 TPI shitmobile in it. There's no point in putting this motor in this car. It's not even a good engine. Look at the rear fenders. That's cool. It covers up the secret tires. It's got secret tires. Yeah. No one ever drives this. It's literally never driven. It is. They're hydraulic pumps. They're for people who haven't discovered airbags yet. No, what they do is they basically make the car go up and down.
Like airbags.
They make the car go up and down really fast.
Yeah.
But they're filled with fluid.
So where do you put your luggage?
There's no luggage. I mean, right in the middle, right there.
But won't it knock around the yeah. materials?
Yeah, it's super irresponsible.
But where do they go to the grocery store?
You don't. People who spend this kind of money on a 64 Impala don't have money for groceries. That's kind of just how it works. But they do have money for $89, like, Panasonic stereos from the early 90s.
No. I think you're wrong, sir. People have plenty of money.
They have money, but it's just distributed oddly. See, this one's airbags. See little pills? That's air. Hydraulics are cool if you want to bounce your car and destroy it. Airbags cool because you can lift it up and down and it doesn't shatter the windows or make the doors not close later. No. Oh, it's a bunch of probably the frame rusting and disintegrating out from underneath the vehicle. Oh, no, that's kitty litter. This thing leaks oil like a son of a bitch. So that's probably just kitty litter soaping up a bunch of oil leaking out of the car.
That's so sad.
Well, nah, that's pretty standard. That's just how it is. Yeah, probably. It's always a guy who's, like, super proud of his car, and then the girl he accidentally hooked up with at a bar, and the kid who has no idea that they don't love him.
You were spilling air.
I know. I was trying to avoid drawing attention to it. It is sexy, though. You don't need headrests. These also don't have seatbelts. Have you noticed that?
I didn't notice that.
In 1964, who's the moron who invented the internet?
I don't know.
His buddy, Ralph. No, Ralph Nader. You know who Ralph Nader is?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's
not dead.
Oh, I thought he died.
Ralph Nader is not dead. He's the guy who made a big deal about how you're way on a different page. Ralph Nader was the guy who was like the Chevy Corvair.
Buzz Aldrin?
No. He said the Chevy Corvair is the car that's not safe at any speed. Because
Chevy Corvair.
No, I'm doing a thing. Chevy Corvair is not is a car that's not safe at any speed. And it wasn't, because it's basically a big, dumb Chevy Volkswagen bug where the engine is in the back, and if you turn a corner really hard, it swings around and everybody dies. Okay. He wasn't wrong. And,
a different kind of car.
Him and, I feel like him and, who's Bill Clinton's vice president? Al Gore, the guy who invented the internet. I feel like I know, but that's just how you refer to him as. I feel like him and him were best friends, but Ralph Nader made a big deal about how that car was not safe at any speed. And then after, like, 1965, it was legally... What are you looking at? What are you looking at? Because it's pink?
Is it, like, sexist because there's a box that says women's in it?
Women's, that's on a bathroom, yes.
Well, what if it's literally women's related and not, like, sexist?
Well,
Well, there better be a whole bunch of breast pumps in there.
Like those sleepy tanks at the airport? Yeah. But because of his aggressive ramblings, cars after like 1965 are legally required to have seatbelts. Like, if you have a 1964 car, you don't need a seatbelt. Because the... No. Like, legal requirements... No. Not true. Legal requirements of the vehicle's safety restraints and airbags and all that stuff are based off of the production year of the vehicle. People need airbags to survive, but legally you can't receive a ticket for not having them. So all these cars can just be wildly unsafe because they're pretty. But it's not important. You don't need an airbag or a seatbelt because fuck it. Yeah, they're all the same car. That's a 1984 Cadillac shitmobile. I don't know. They're not very good.
It smells like my grandpa.
Look at the fancy cars.
They're so fancy.
You can tell because the doors go up. Not like this. Not like this, but like this. Yeah, because they're behind a rope. I tried to race one of these in traffic the other day, but I was driving my whatever shitmobile and they weren't having it.
Yeah.
It's kind of a bummer.
You should have got one of these for your reunion.
An Infiniti?
No, this. You rent a shitty fancy car?
Nah. Well, the thing is I showed up in the reunion. No, I showed up at the reunion in an Aston Martin, and no one cared because... Well, my reunion, it was at a place where literally there was no vehicle parking.
Yeah.
So it wouldn't have mattered. They never would have seen it.
Someone would have had to drive, and I wanted to get drunk. And I did.
And there's some dumb Porsches. God, these cars are really bumming me out. It's funny, like, Porsche takes the spot up here because they know they're not going to come up with anything groundbreaking. So they're like, let's not use up any of the expensive floor space. Let's just go up here because we have to.
Yeah.
But let's not, like, actually show off because that costs bucks. They could even bring...
How do they get the cars up here?
There's an elevator. Whoops. This one might be cool only because there's like a plug on it. It's got a plug on it.
Let's investigate.
I want your opinion.
Well, these have fancy screens.
Everything up here smells deep fried.
Very oily. Oh, the seatbelts are yellow. Interesting.
The yellow seatbelts are supposed to be from their sports line. They're not supposed to put that on the regular, like, electric cars. That's dumb. They do have the hologram thing, though. This thing here, it paints the, like, speedometer on the windshield.
That seems distracting.
It's kind of distracting. It's stupid. It's a cheap gimmick. Chevy's been doing it with, like, the Corvettes from the early 90s.
Yeah.
So it's not special.
Mm.
That's the electric Jaguar mini SUV thing, but it's pretty gross, too, from what I understand. Ooh, this one's almost the green that my Jaguar was green. It's too dark, though.
Yeah. 14.
I want to go look at the electric one. It's so dirty. Look at the fender.
Everyone's finger-pumped. That's what happens.
I like how they have the thing around it. Like, don't get in here, and everybody's just fucking with it.
Or maybe it's just a line to get in there. I think that's what it is.
Mm.
So you don't bring your beer in there.
The thing is they're making it... It's not any different than a regular car.
unless you drive it, you would not notice the difference, which is what they should be doing.
Yeah.
It should just be a regular car.
Oh, no, there's a don't look at me kid.
Isn't that bad for their well-being?
Well, we're going to check out some exotics.
Yeah.
Sorry. I didn't do anything.
No, it smells like cigarettes and body odor.
EV400, huh?
It's got a weird butt.
I want to care about it so much, and I just don't.
I mean, it's not doing anything for me. Here's the elevator. I found it.
The car elevator or people elevator? Oh, all right. Oh, God. Oh, my God, look at this.
I saw it.
This is the play area. So, look, count the seats, right? So we looked at that Toyota that will last forever with 8 seats and a V6. And then you can look at this Range Rover and you can impress your other coffee date girlfriends.
Oh, this is cool though. I just touched the button.
Oh my God, who gives a fuck?
Well, I'm just saying, no, it's 2 seats back here.
And that button probably works 100 times and then it dies. Maybe 50 times. I would buy 2 of the Toyotas for the same price as this. And then 2 people could enjoy that truck for the same amount of time for probably twice the warranty period. It's hard to fathom why people buy these things. I don't get it. And like this rear window, you can't put anything in the back. Because the window isn't...
It takes up all the space.
The Velar. This is the Top Gear one, or the Grand Tour one. The Velar. It beeped at me. Yeah, the other one doesn't have to touch. Yeah, it doesn't touch you as much. Like, what's the point? The Toyota. It literally just boils down to, is it better or worse than the Toyota? This is the car show. The car show is it Toyota? Is it Toyota quality? Better, worse, equal, Toyota quality? That's an electric one too. Look at the grill.
Oh, cool.
That's kind of neat. But not important. Ooh, it does. Oh, it's just not...
Jesus, that doesn't help at all.
Jesus. Oh no, my signal is dying.
Well, we're gonna get out in a minute if we're lucky. I can't breathe.
There's so much shenanigans here.
We should say,
Saab parking only? Do I have worthless Kia parking only? Where's Kia? There's Volkswagen, that's pretty worthless. Mustang's not that worthless. It's pretty worthless. Mustangs don't park. Mustangs crash into humans. Maserati. I need Kia parking because they're broken down. Where's that button?
Sexy senior parking only. That's not incorrect. Where Infinity parking, that's similar. Infinity is Nissan. Nissan parking only. Oh, I want a Lotus. The Lotus will be cool because they have, well, at least the recent ones, they have the Toyota engine. You may have noticed there's a theme.
This looks like somebody like raided Hobby Lobby. They have one show.
That is weird. Why would you spell it wrong? Oh, because of the copyright. You do I-N. It doesn't...
Then what about all these other ones?
Are they O-N? I mean...
No, they're just like small bright. Ford logo.
Aston Martin might give a shit more or something. Or somebody who literally wrote this is retarded. Welcome to the Nut House. Oh my god. Look at this purple bug.
Oh, it's so cute.
It's so purple. Yeah, it's like the most purple thing I've ever seen in my life. If I cared about purple that much, that'd actually be super dope. Mini Cooper's lame. Camaro's lame. That bug.
The bug is pretty good.
Oh my god. Miami-Dade County. It's the Kill Bill. It's.
He likes the truck car.
Yeah.
It's the pussy wagon. They do tend to do that. Look, it's Betty Boop's side boob.
Oops.
Yikes.
Fear helping other people have sex. It's like you've been doing that
since 1862? Yeah, no, much longer than that.
Thank you.
It's funny to watch these, like, Mustang pride things happen. Yeah. And it's, like, the cool Mustang, and then they just turn into, like, a glob of garbage. And you still have to pretend like you're a Mustang fan. It's like, no one liked that. It was trash. All these are terrible. These are just, like, bad ass. It's like, no, it wasn't bad. You're just saying it because you want to pretend that it was.
Yeah. Did you get the same as Bruce?
Drones. We got a rally fighter. I saw one of these in Bellevue one time. The taillights are off of a Honda. It's stupid. This guy's selling so many wax. He's selling the most amount of wax ever. So, the entire car show, we've seen every single vehicle ever made and is going to be made in the near future, and it's just by a Toyota?
Pretty much.
Why is it always just by a Toyota? It's so boring. Let's look at this Buick with a convertible. Stupid. Oh my god, everything smells like a chemical toilet. No, you're gonna sit in the driver's seat. Why don't they put the door locks where you can reach them? Just put the door locks here. Some cars do that even. It's not even that big of a deal. Oh my god. Hold my beer. F. You know how many buttons they have? I don't like the amount of buttons. It's too many buttons. Whoops.
Alright, so you've got electric parking brake, cool. This is, I imagine, a window and a room.
Whatever.
A really nice awful auxiliary port, I assume, for radio. Way too many buttons. Guess who's buying a Buick?
You.
No.
Old people.
There you go. What do old people hate?
Everything.
No, but specifically.
Meddling kids.
This isn't a goddamn Scooby-Doo situation. Look what I'm looking at.
They wouldn't be able to see any of this stuff. That's the problem.
These numbers, these buttons, the graphics are too small. They say SRCE, Navi, Phone, AS1/2, FAV1/2/3, P, bling, 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 triangle, underline, whatever. No. Chinese people are buying Buicks. They need to stop pretending that the elderly or the Buick buying elderly community still exists. It's gone. The brand name is worthless. This car makes no sense at all. It's too many buttons. It needs like 4 buttons. It needs a big button here, a big button here. Like the play toys that you give a toddler. You need 1, 2, 3, 4. It's got 724 buttons. I don't care about any of them. There's a cigarette lighter port for some reason, a poorly
identified auxiliary. Oh my god. This thing is terrible. This is the one car that has a cool thing that I thought every other car should have, though. Let's get out. The only redeeming factor of this vehicle
is what?
I'm getting a phone call. I want to decline. There we go. The only redeeming factor is, and I have to find the button for it. Where is the button? Where's the button? I gotta open the trunk. So you're gonna help me open the trunk. No. Where is the trunk button? That's my asshole. Where's the trunk button? God damn it. Is there no trunk button? No, you have to open the trunk. The only good thing on this entire car is the trunk. I need a rep. Here. I need a beer, and I'm gonna go bother this rep.
Oh, here, this girl, she can help us.
Yes. I tried that. It didn't work.
That's because it's got to refresh it. Hang on.
I know, right? Okay. There's one cool thing the trunk does. Can you hold this again? Second set of taillights. So when you break down on the end and the side of the road and you pop the trunk for a reason or another, you have a second set of taillights. That's the only car that has it. That's it. So is there no way to release the trunk from the inside of the vehicle?
I don't think so.
That seems strange. That was actually what I was trying to like. Well, what if you don't have the key fob? There is literally no way to release the trunk from inside the vehicle. I looked real hard. Wait. You have it from the key fob or on the back? But the back didn't work unless the key fob unlocked it. So it unlocks with the doors. No, I understand. What I'm saying is that I've been hitting this button, and until I bothered you...
Right, no. So that happens to all of our cars.
The doors have to be unlocked to make this function.
Well, maybe, but what I'm saying is that all the cars go through a process of where we have to refresh them.
time just due to people coming in and out. They accidentally set off the silent alarms and then things lock up.
Okay.
So I just had to refresh it.
I don't know what refresh means, but...
I'm hitting the button on the keyboard.
No, I understand. That's weird. Thank you.
Have a good day.
Thanks.
And that is how we not sell a car. She... What was she talking about, though? But that didn't make any sense. So, I said, you unlock the car with the remote. And she's like, no, what you do is you unlock the car with the remote. I felt like an asshole.
What she actually said is she didn't know. All she knew that was because it was running on the battery pack, it wasn't behaving as it would normally in the real world. It's not running off the car's battery.
And I told her I understood that.
So she said she didn't know.
Just say you don't know.
She didn't know.
Why does she have to play like I'm a moron? Just say, oh, you know what? You know what? I think, you know what? You figured it out. Just let me have it. Don't make me feel like a dipshit.
It's like admitting weakness.
Well, it is weakness because she fucking showed up to a goddamn car show and she doesn't know how the one car she's supposed to describe to people how it works. She has no idea how it fucking works.
Her job is to be pretty and hit up magazines.
She's not that pretty. I'm going to hell. Whatever. I don't care. God damn it. Oh, look at this robot man. He does, like, dances and stuff. Restart.
See you tomorrow. He's done for the
day. I'm going to make him do Ford Flex. Is he going to, like, flex? Look, his junk says... Hank, like it would normally say Ford. I don't know what's happening. It's not doing anything. Hank, you're worthless. Look, it's a Ford that probably does none of the things that Toyota does for twice the price, right? It's a really... It's really tall. I like the fact that it's super tall. It's got to be cheaper.
66.
I see a seatbelt in the ceiling. Seatbelts in the ceiling are like my new favorite thing. But... Ugh. Oh my god. Can you hold this?
Oh, someone else had the beer here. That's funny.
I saw that, but theirs is empty. Because they like to party harder than I do. Oh my god, I can't even grab it with my fingers. How do I get the seat up? Is it electric? 3L. Oh my god, it's electric. I just hit a random button and it started lifting up on its own. That's fucking dope. It smells like hell though. Alright, so I'm gonna climb. No, it's alright. I'm gonna climb in. And I want... I need to... Oh,
the other side.
No, I got it. I know how this works. I'm a... Don't woman-splain this to me.
I will explain all I want.
Look, you plug in the thing, and then you go like this, and then you go like this, and then it's boom. That was actually pretty... That was easy like the first one. I like that. This doesn't make any sense at all. 3L, 2L, seat, 2M, 3R, 2R?
Three left, three right, two left, two right.
It's still...
Second row right, third row.
It's... You don't need electric seats for this.
I almost drank your beer.
It's too much electricity for not enough...
I like electric seats.
It's a cool idea, but they never work and they always burn out. Plan on having this car for 5 years... 3.5 years into a vehicle, at least it's trash. I was trying to close it on my head, but it didn't do anything. It's unplugged. I need to go ask that woman how electronics work.
Look at this little tiny baby Escape. It's adorable. I want one. Buy me one. I want it. Actually, I want the Flex. Buy me a Flex. Look at it. It's so good. EcoBoost? Is this the twin turbo or a single turbo? It's so good. It is super ugly, but it's got like woody sides. It's got woody sides minus the wood. Yeah, they're kind of a couple of bucks. Is it? Well, then buy the Toyota. Watch this. I'm going to hit these buttons and they're going to do stuff. Stow. No, they're all broken.
Oh, they need to be reset.
Are they still selling the Taurus? Holy shit. Why would anybody buy a Ford Taurus? It's not that fast. 350 horsepower is garbage. Yeah, well, no one buying that either. It's a cop car. You can buy these things used with 120,000 miles for $9,000. Way too much. Oh, they're just, I don't know. EcoSport. The EcoSport is adorable. It's a Chevy Trax that doesn't suck. It's chock full of yoga mats. I don't even know if that's somebody that... somebody left them there, or it's just genuinely full of yoga mats. No, this thing's dope. It's like a tiny little Focus. Yeah, this is the bullet one with the terrible wheels. It's a good Mustang, but the wheels are just dog shit. Want to want an Edge, but there's no point for it. It doesn't need to exist. You get an ST Edge? That's like the turbo and all the... ugh. Look at the gap over here. Oh, the door is open. Okay, I was like, oh my god, if that's the fit and finish, holy shit. It's, oh, the tape is on the thing. I can't close it. It's heavy. Ugh. Go, open, open, open. But it's not that huge. This needs to extend out to here and then go down. And oh my God, you'll lose 0.7 miles per gallon, but you'll actually have usable storage. Otherwise, you're stuck with these dumb little side windows. Okay.
What time is it?
I don't know. It is 7:46.
If I can get a Toyota in that red color, that'd be pretty dope.
That is a Toyota in that red color.
You need like a better one than that.
You could probably special order it. If it's in their catalog, you'll have to pay full sticker.
Nah.
That's something you're used to doing, right?
Never paid full sticker.
I'm not a fucking amateur.
Actually, my current car is the first new car I've ever had in my life.
And
it wasn't even
it
new.
It wasn't even new because you did it right?
I would never buy a brand new car.
It's super stupid, right?
There's no need.
I remember wanted to buy the third new car from the Ford dealer.
Yeah.
And the guy was like, oh, every time you come and buy a car from us, we've lost $4,000.
Yeah.
I'm like, yeah, because I'm doing my job.
Yeah.
He was so blown away. I'm like, no, that's just, what is wrong with you?
And right.
Ooh, I have to pee too. All right, I'm going to end my video on one of these Toyotas, and then I'm just going to kill it. Because there's literally no point in buying anything other than one of these trucks. Maybe not this one, but...